What's going on, you Boruto fans? I'm Predictable 60 here, bringing you guys the next review on episode 40. I know it's been a couple of weeks since I've last done this. They did not actually have the episode come out last week because it was like a holiday week or something like that, according to what the website said. So now that they have actually brought out episode 40, I have been very entertained with this episode, and they have come back strong, I have to say. This was a very entertaining episode. We got to see Boruto now with Team 7. This is now the new and improved, I guess, generation. Team 7, and of course I wouldn't really say improved because you can never be better than the original, but of course we now have Konohamaru, Mitsuki, Boruto, and Sarada. So now we have the full, or like not really original, but like I said, the new generation Team 7. And of course, before I get started, let me just go ahead and say go ahead and subscribe for those of you who are Boruto fans, because there will be more of these videos coming your way. I know I've been kind of slacking here lately, but that's just been due to work and all this kind of stuff. I have two different jobs, so I'm just kind of trying to make time when I can to make these videos and bring content to you guys, so just bear with me. I will be trying to keep this stuff up. I have been seeing the growth, so I do appreciate you all who have subscribed. Just go ahead and continue to do that so we can continue to grow as a community, and that way we can actually make some kind of career off of this, because I really do enjoy bringing this entertainable content to you guys. But of course, just go ahead and subscribe, hit the bell symbol too, to get notified about all latest Boruto content that will be coming to this channel. But let's get right into this thing, because I do want to discuss how we now have a new arc inbound, and we've now seen this person named Ashimaru, and he seems like a very skilled ninja. He looks pretty serious, and he looks kind of crazy. He almost reminds me of the shark guy. Why? Help me. But yeah, we now have a new enemy, and at first we were told that they were just there trying to steal stuff from this supply warehouse that they have in this one village, and of course, that's not even the case. They said that this is more about a deed to the bridge, a bridge that they want, and I'm very convinced that this guy who is like the one who made the bridge is the guy from Naruto, when Naruto first started, and when Naruto went on his first mission. I don't know that guy's name, it's been a while, but I do feel that he is the one that built this bridge, just for the simple fact that, we don't know anybody. I mean, like they've done so far, they brought back a lot of old people and just kind of, you know, reintroduced some old faces, and I just feel like now this is just someone coming back, and they might even show who built this bridge. They may not, but I mean, just to me, it just seems like they would have some type of, you know, influence on that. But of course, like I said, this episode was pretty, I guess, entertaining. They came back strong. They didn't disappoint. I actually enjoyed the little bit of fighting that was taking place here. And of course, nobody got hurt for real. I mean, it was just kind of a quick conflict, quick scuffle. No one really got injured. But Ashimaru seems like he's going to give Konohamaru a run for his money, because he definitely gave Boruto a hard time. Boruto almost did not stand a chance. There was no jutsu really involved in this episode besides Sarada's Sharingan and, of course, Genjutsu. But, I mean, there was no real, like, techniques taking place here. There was nothing that really showed that, you know, something was about to happen, like something more serious was about to go down. Not just yet, but we do see the build up here. We do see that they're working on trying to get you more wrapped up in this episode. And it doesn't take much, especially when it comes to Boruto, stuff like this, or Naruto. It's very easy for them to wrap me into this because I'm so into Naruto in general, and just me being a big fan that I am, I just find it easy for me to like just be interested at the smallest thing. And I know a lot of you are probably like, well, you know, not everything about this show is interesting, so you like the fillers too. And I mean, in Naruto Shippuden, when they brought the fillers, it was just kind of like they're trying to drag out episodes, drag out a fight, or drag out some kind of arc, and it was just kind of annoying. But me being a true fan, I powered through them and I watched them, because some of them were very interesting, like the Ashura and Indira arc. That was pretty interesting. I did enjoy that one, like legit sat there and was like, wow, this is pretty cool how they, you know, introduced how ninjutsu even got started. So that was pretty cool. But there's been like the Kakashi arc and all that kind of stuff, how they grew up and everything with Obito and all that good stuff. But you know, it's been very cool so far. We've only seen one filler to me. That was Mitsuki's origins, and that was pretty cool. That was the last video I uploaded. That was actually really interesting to watch, because we got to see a really cool fight with Orochimaru, and of course, Mitsuki is what he called himself, so that was very interesting to see. And this guy, like I was saying, Ashimaru reminds me of Kisame. You know, they have that look in their eyes, like they're fucking crazy fuckers, like that crazy I'm gonna kill you no matter what look, like you can't stop me. They have that person that can talk to calm them down, like Kisame had Itachi to, you know, be like, dude, relax, it's just a mission, all right, do not have to go overboard. So you had someone to keep him in check, and you got this guy. I don't know who's really keeping him in check, but this is just all interesting to me. And of course, you know, just let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, because we've seen a good bit of stuff in this episode. And like I said, I'm pretty sure things are just going to continue to pick up. And when they really get serious, because I know that next episode they're actually going to fight a little bit. But we do know that things are going to really pick up on this one. And this mission just itself has become something more than what it was supposed to be. So what was the whole point of her even telling Naruto that, you know, it was just something to keep bandits away? I guess she just wanted to know that she was going to have a fit team to come in here and try to take over and do what they can to help her, you know, secure her own life, I guess. But again, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Until next time, guys, go ahead and just subscribe and you go the extra mile if you want to, and just go ahead and click that bell symbol, like the video, and share it with as many people as possible so we can get the word out there that we exist and we want to grow. But until next time, guys, there will be vlogs coming your way too. I just want to go ahead and point that out. If you made it this far to the end of the video, there will be vlogs coming your way. Some interesting vlogs, so just stay tuned for that. And until next time, guys, this has been your broadcast. Unpredictable is signing off.